Although it's a newer type, the A380 has several operational disadvantages when compared to the A340, disadvantages that have already forced many airlines to retire the superjumbo over the course of the pandemic. If we combine this phenomenon with the fact that sanction-starved countries are forced to operate old jets, then we could indeed see older A340 jets remain in active commercial service longer than A380s. The Airbus A340 took its first flight in 1991, while the A380 Superjumbo lifted off on its maiden voyage 14 years later in 2005. This makes the A380 much newer and an aircraft type that you would expect to be flying further into the future. However, there are some key operational differences that put the A380 at a disadvantage. It's harder to fill, its routes are more limited due to volume and airport access, and it's expensive to operate. We've already seen a number of airlines make the tough decision to phase out the A380 from their respective fleets. These include Air France, Etihad, Malaysia Airlines, and Thai Airways. As for Airbus's other four-engined aircraft, the A340 continues to fly with almost as many active examples as the A380. A recent study found that just under 80 A340s were listed as active through planespotters.net. While this is less than the 90-plus A380s marked active, it's important to remember that the last A340 was produced in 2010, well over a decade ago. We should say, however, that quite a few A340s listed as active are flying as VIP or government transports. Governments listed as operating VIP-configured A340s include Algeria, Germany, Kuwait, Turkey, and many more. Still, many A340s do indeed continue to fly passengers commercially. Airlines include Lufthansa, Swiss, and Edelweiss Air. In Iran, Azerman Airlines and Mahan Air continue to operate the type as well. As we see it, two main factors will determine the aircraft type that operates commercial service the longest: how long sanctioned countries like Iran can continue to operate the A340, and when Emirates will decide to retire its fleet completely. Starved by sanctions, Iran and its airlines have been forced to operate aircraft for much longer than operators in other parts of the world who have the ability to purchase newer, more efficient jets. This is why, in addition to the A340, we see the A300 and A310 types still active with Iranian carriers. If sanctions continue into the future, the A340 could still be flying in this part of the world. As for the A380, it looks like Emirates could be the last operator flying the type. The Dubai-based airline took delivery of the very last A380 to ever be produced and has also invested in refurbishing some of its older superjumbos. The airline has plans to operate the A380 into the mid-2030s, giving us a little more than a decade of service. Ultimately, these two factors will keep us guessing for the next 5 to 10 years, if not longer. While the longevity of aircraft is typically dictated by economics, the Iranian situation forces operators to ignore this factor and continue flying what's available. On the other hand, the laws of economics still apply to the A380, and this means that its operators will give up on the type once more efficient and profitable options exist, mainly the Boeing 777X. For now, it seems to be a competition that's just too close to call. Which aircraft type do you think will outlive the other? Is your bet on the older but more versatile A340, or are you betting on the A380? Share your prediction by leaving a comment. In addition to our daily YouTube videos, Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.